To disassemble and reassemble your Nokia Lumia 610, you will need a T5 Torx Star-type screwdriver, a plastic separation tool of some kind, and possibly a pair of tweezers. So make sure the phone's switched off and remove the back cover. Remove your battery. Take out your micro SIM card, and now we need to undo 8 T5 Torx screws around the outside. You can skip any stage by clicking the link at the top of the video. And don't worry about getting them mixed up, they're all the same size. Now, using your plastic tool, we need to release a few clips around the outside. Start by releasing the clip that's just on this corner here. So insert your separation tool and that's released. Then come round to the back and there's a clip just here. Just push that in there and release that. That's released. And there's one just here. And come over to the other side, there's one just here, and that's all the clips released. Then carefully lift the back up, and don't worry if the keys fall out, put them back later. So on the back cover we have the headphone socket. It's held in with double sided tape. If you need to replace it, you can gently ease that out and put your new one back in again. The LED flash can be removed, so lift that up, and that's held in with double sided tape. When you put it back in, make sure you line up the little flat corner there with the case. The speaker can be replaced, but it might be damaged if you try and remove it, so only take this out if you need to. Now we need to unplug the two ribbon cables. This one's for the display screen, so lift that up and push that out of the way, and this one's for the digitizer, so be careful of the components nearby and lift that up and push that away. There's two clips holding the main board in. There's one just there and there, so carefully lift the screen up and that clips popped off, and this one, just lift it up, and now we can lift the main board up and gently lift that out. So this is your secondary microphone at the top and your proximity sensor. This is your main microphone at the bottom. There's your camera switch, power switch and volume switches. This is a rechargeable battery that keeps the time and date while you change the main battery. There's your vibrating module, micro USB port, and the camera is replaceable using a special tool that releases the clips and it can be taken out. If you're replacing the display or the digitizer, start by lifting up the display. You'll find it comes away quite easy as it's not stuck down. Try not to touch the glass if you're reusing it. Before you replace the digitizer, make sure you remove these small rubber gaskets as they tend to fall off quite easily. This is the microphone gasket, and there's a small proximity sensor gasket at the top here. You can buy these digitizers with and without the frame. If you've bought one with the frame, you can skip this step by clicking the link at the top of the video. To remove the digitizer from the frame, get it nice and warm with a fan heater or hairdryer and push from behind, and push it up, and it will slowly and slowly come unstuck. As you're pushing it away, try to keep the double-sided tape on the frame, and eventually it will come away. Just carefully bring the ribbon cable through the case, and if the double-sided tape can't be reused, then you could replace it with new double-sided tape, or you could even glue the digitizer back in place and use a new frame the next time you replace it. If you need to replace the earpiece, when you lift this up, it tends to damage the earpiece, so only remove it if you need to replace it. So to reassemble, start by putting your ribbon cable through into the housing and bring that in and around into place. Make sure it lines up around the outside, and once you're happy it's lined up, just give it a good push down into place. Then we can replace those small rubber gaskets. So this one, have it round that way with a little tag at the top, and this one, so the small corner cutout lines up with the case. Now, before you put your display back on, you need to pull off the protective coating on your new digitizer. And if you have a new display, pull the protective coating off that as well. Make sure the ribbon cable is at the bottom of the phone and offer that up into place. Now we can replace the mainboard, so make sure this ribbon cable's pushed out of the way. Take your mainboard with the USB port at the top and offer that up into place so it fits nicely flush and it goes all the way in, so that the board is right up against the stop there on both sides. Once you're happy that's pushed in far enough, we can bring the main board down into place. So you've got a small clip just there, and there's one just there. So if you're happy everything's in place, we'll reconnect the digitizer and reconnect the display. Now we can put the buttons back on. This can be a little bit fiddly, so make sure you have the slope in the right place, so it slopes towards the front of the phone, and offer that up into place, making sure that these little plastic parts line up with the recess. So that's nicely in place, and the small power button, again make sure those little plastic tags go into the casing . It's a little bit fiddly, almost there. There we go. And finally, the camera button. Make sure that little tag goes in. And Now ready to put the rear cover on. So offer up the rear cover with the headphone socket at the top and offer that into the top of the phone. Make sure it goes all the way in and watch out for the keys. Make sure they don't move and just gently move it around until it clicks down into place. Now we can replace the 8 screws. Again, you can skip this by clicking the link at the top of the video. And only do the screws up finger tight or you'll snap them off. Replace your micro SIM card. Replace the battery. Replace your back cover. And we should have a fully repaired Nokia Lumia 610. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and give me the thumbs up, and I'll do my best to make some more.